and pasta folded in burrata, tomato sauce, and wrapped in layers of grilled eggplant. Bakes together for a dinner that's almost too beautiful to eat.
It's like an eggplant pasta cake. Welcome back, everyone. Our next guest is going to show us how to make a very impressive dish that you would probably see at a fine Italian restaurant, but you can absolutely make at home. I promise you, look at that. Please welcome the author of Meal and a Spiel, Chef Alana Horowitz. Welcome, Alana.
Thank you. Thanks for having me.
Also joining Cam at the counter, Maria and Larissa, who are very excited for this very unusual and beautiful dish. Tell us the story behind this. It's so neat.
Yes, so this is called a timballo di melanzane, which literally means an eggplant pasta drum. It's like an eggplant pasta cake. Exactly. So we just have grilled eggplant. We're going to fill it with pasta. And this is something that is used for Italian holidays or a special occasion. But like you just said, it's really simple. And I've taught so many beginners to make it.
Which you're going to do with us today. Yes. This is quite beautiful. It looks as beautiful as it tastes. So we just start with our grilled eggplant, right?
We just start with grilled eggplant. So what we're doing is we're lining this springform pan with eggplant, making sure that everything overlaps so that it can carry the weight of the pasta. Okay. So we've just lined the bottom, and this eggplant has been just simply grilled with olive oil. That's it, just olive oil on a hot grill pan. I teach my cooking students to use an indoor grill pan because I find it to be really easy, really accessible.
Okay, no salt even?
Salt is going to be in the pasta sauce.
Beautiful.
Yeah.
Alana, I want you to know I went to structural engineering school, and I feel like you're building a structure. Like, I feel like this is like old school construction.
That's what she's doing.
All right.
Okay, so we've got that.
The next.
At least for now. Then we make our pasta, right?
Okay, so then you make your pasta. So what's really important about making the pasta is that you're not cooking it to al dente. You're cooking it to 4 minutes before al dente.
Okay.
Because it's going to bake again in the oven. So we don't want it to be mushy at the end.
Okay.
So we're gonna take our pasta and we're gonna put it in this hot tomato sauce, okay?
And how do you make your tomato sauce?
It's so simple. I mean, the Italian thing is all about not a lot of ingredients, but really good quality ingredients. So this is sauteed garlic, olive oil, a little red pepper flakes, a can of San Marzano tomatoes, basil. I do put a couple carrot sticks in there, which I then take out because it sweetens the sauce.
Without the sugar. Exactly.
I don't wanna add.
Me too.
Yeah, that's, so that's what's really important to me.
Yep.
So then we're going to add burrata. I know. So burrata is like a mozzarella, but filled with cream. And it's just going to, it's the best. And fresh basil.
I'm so excited.
And just
Maria, are you
going to
be okay?
I just got really excited. I've never heard of burrata being in something like this. I usually hear of the mozzarella, but the burrata is the best.
Oh, it's in, look at what happens right now as you mix together the pasta with the burrata. It just all melts.
Oh, burrata is what Nick Mozzarella wishes it was.
You know, the thing is also in the United States, it's really possible to find good burrata. It's harder to find good mozzarella, to be honest with you. But look at that.
Now,
listen, if you were to have cooked your dish, cooked your pasta fully, this you can just serve this.
Yeah.
This could be the meal.
We can stop right here.
You could stop right there. Yeah, we could totally stop right there. Okay, so this is our beautiful pasta. Okay, Debbie, I'm going to ask you to give me a hand. I'll hold the pot. You pour this in.
Oh, my goodness. Okay, I don't want to get it all over you.
No, you're good. You're good. Just go for it.
So good.
Alana.
I know.
That is like, it looks like a present.
My God, that is an Italian Christmas right there.
This is visually kind of over the top. It's pretty amazing.
And even open-faced, it would be beautiful.
Yeah. Well, it would. Yeah, you're right. It would be. So listen, now we're just going to put grilled eggplant on the top.
Okay.
Right? We have to finish off our cake,
like
our timballo. And then we just why don't you help me, Debbie? We're just going to fold them over.
Now, would you always use eggplant? Could you use anything else?
People ask this question because not everybody loves eggplant, but I have to tell you, everyone that has tasted this in my cooking classes loves eggplant at the end of it. You have to have something that will hold it. There are timballi, that's the plural, made from pastry. But then you have to roll out pastry, and that's a whole thing. This is much easier, and it's lighter.
Yeah, that's right. That's right.
Okay, so this just goes in the oven.
For how long?
It goes in at 350 for a half an hour.
Do you have to have a spring form?
For this, you do need a spring form pan. And I know a lot of cooks are intimidated about spring form pans. So I would just say, try it a little adventure.
Okay.
Yeah,
and they're not that expensive either.
No.
And then you can make a cheesecake.
And you can do other things with it. I was scared of a springform pan for years before I started. So I would just say, take a little adventure.
Yeah.
And now here's for the real test.
Okay, so here.
Will our timballo come out correctly?
Right, let's see. Okay, so we're going to just put a plate on top of it.
Oh, that's so much easier.
Okay, ready? One, two, three. And now we just open up our timballo. Now,
something that is also very important, though, you want to make sure that once you do take it out of the oven, you do wait a few minutes, right?
It needs to be about 10 minutes so that it, otherwise it will kind of fall apart.
A little nervous. Why would I be nervous with you in the kitchen?
Well, you know what? It's okay. Even if it falls apart, it would still be delicious.
Yes,
so there
absolutely.
You go.
That's
so
true. But well done, guys.
Yeah, so this is Parmigiano Reggiano, right? The real stuff. Oh, so you want to just sprinkle it with some Parmigiano, and then we are going to go ahead and cut this.
Yay!
Okay, time to serve. As you're serving it, I'd love to hear all about your meal and a spiel philosophy. Tell us about it.
Yeah, thank you. Well, for me, as a cooking teacher, what I have found that the biggest obstacle for people learning to cook is fear. Mm-hmm. They're so scared that they're gonna mess up and it's not gonna be perfect. So what I try to do is dissolve that fear, help them move through the fear, and I do that by, look at this.
My gosh.
Oh
that
my gosh.
So
I can't even stand what I'm
looking
do that
right
through
now.
Storytelling and humor and empowering people to be intuitive cooks, which means that they don't have to be married to recipes and they can cook from
that.
The heart.
I love that.
So really cooking is a chance for us to be playful, and adults don't get enough chances to just be playful. So
good for you. I think that's a really good thing that you're doing there.
Yeah, tell me.
Ilana, I feel like you just took us on a trip to Italy.
Well, you know, and that's the thing. I actually believe that we can eat as well in the United States as we can in Italy. We have all the ingredients. We have all the tools. We just have to know what to do with them.
Va bene. How about this, everybody? All right, full recipe, go to HallmarkChannel.com and connect with Ilana on her website, mealandaspiel.com as well.